गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू थिंक आई चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस कंपटेटिव एथनोग्राफी। चैप्टर इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू एथनोग्राफी एंड राइटिंग कल्चर्स। टॉपिक इज इंटरप्रिटेटिव। क्लिफर्ड गीड्स, एन एंथ्रोपोलॉजिस्ट, हैज प्रोड्यूस सम ऑफ द मोस्ट रीड एथनोग्राफीज इन द डिसिप्लिन एंड इज अ मास्टर ऑफ वॉट ही टर्म एज थिक डिस्क्रिप्शन, अ टर्म बोरोड फ्रॉम फिलोसोफर गिलबर्ट राइल, an attempt to go into the minutest detail of an event in order to elucidate the meaning it has for the actors and how this meaning can be exaggerated or extracted for the purpose of explanation for the readers. His view of culture was to describe it as not an experimental science in search of law, but an interpretative one in search of meaning. Who said this? Geertz, 1973. Thick description was likewise looking into the layers of meaning that is imposed on an act. What we call data are really our own constructions of other people's constructions of what they and their compatriots are up to. His ethnographic method consisted of trying to put oneself in somebody else's skin in order to bring that is for someone an experience near concept to another for whom, because that person is not part of that situation or culture, an experience distant concept. Ethnography will thus involve not just regarding or recording. Ethnography will thus involve not just recording what people say on your face, but how they say it, with what nuance, what shades of meanings and expression, using what kind of symbolism to capture exactly what is actually meant rather than what is said. Ultimately, explanation would mean contextualizing an isolated meaning into a larger context of meaning system of that culture. Thus each time and thus each item of culture, say it is the famous Balinese, Balinese, Balinese cook, cock, cockfight, Balinese cockfight, murgo ki ladai. Thus each item of culture, say it is the famous Balinese cockfight or the theater state of Bali, makes sense against the culture in its entirety. That is, one need to move back and forth between the part and the whole in order to explain what Geertz referred to as the hermeneutic circle. Hermeneutic circle. Geertz, 1974, said that something he feels is central to the ethnographic interpretation. Although Geertz is concerned with the meaning system generated by a culture, his approach remains positivist, as explanation and understanding are located in the scholar and not in the field. But the debate generated between Evans Pritchard and Peter Winch about the ontological status of natives' beliefs is not addressed by him. Yule, 1984. For example, Evans Pritchard explained witchcraft among the Azande as an act that plays a functional role in containing actual hostility and have practical utility. They are not true. Evans Pritchard is refuting Levi Bruhel's contention that the primitive mind is pre-logical, that is, it cannot distinguish between fiction and reality. Like it does believe that witchcraft is true, but here Winch, following Wittgenstein, raises the important question as to who is privileged to talk about reality. In other words, what Winch is saying is that since Western science and Azande witchcraft are two different systems of rationality based on very different premises, they are not comparable. There is no actual basis for doubting the ontological status of Azande witchcraft using Western scientific logic or methodology. In other words, truth is not context independent but context dependent. Western science is but one of the many other systems of thought. Thus, Evans Pritchard tried to make use of what Durkheim has called a social fact, a fact that has reality outside of the ethnographic context. To him, an ethnographic fact is different from the universal social fact in that it is contextualized into the interpretation of the field, yet its analytical position is outside of the consciousness of the informants. Thus, while the Azande beliefs in the witchcraft are rational within their own system of the interpretation, they are not true as per the rationality of the Western science. The contention of the Winch is that Western science cannot identify the truth status of any act outside of its own field. As for anything to be considered true, it has to be situated within and not outside of the fundamental assumptions on which they are based. Such criticism of the universal acceptance of the Western science as the only sanctifying system of knowledge has been raised by feminist scholars like Donna Haraway and others, who have shown that knowledge does not have any existence outside of the subjective consciousness of those who produce it, especially as far as it concerns the human subject.